There are some types of lymphomas that in some cases cannot be cured with first-line conventional chemotherapy. And in these clinical situations, an autologous stem cell transplant is the standard of care. Basically, an autologous stem cell transplantation only represents the administration to the patient of high-dose chemotherapy. The problem is that the stem cells of the bone marrow are very sensitive to high-dose chemotherapy, and if we don't collect stem cells either from the bone marrow or the peripheral blood before the patient receives this high-dose chemotherapy, then the patient, the possibilities that the patient has to recover from the hematological toxicity of the chemotherapy are very low, and patients could eventually remain with very low platelet count, so at high risk of bleeding, with very low red blood cell count, so anemic, and very low leukocyte count, so at a very high risk of developing infection. So the curative potential of the autologous stem cell transplantation part is the high-dose chemotherapy that we give to the patient, and this is the standard of care basically for Hodgkin lymphoma, diffuse large B-cell lymphoma, and follicular lymphoma patients that are in second complete remission, so that they have failed conventional chemotherapy. But of course, we need to collect these stem cells, nowadays basically from the peripheral blood, before transplanting the patient. And what we use is what we call mobilization strategies. So it means that in a steady state situation, the number of peripheral blood stem cells is very low, but we can stimulate the bone marrow in different ways, and the bone marrow releases a lot of these stem cells into the peripheral blood, and these stem cells can be easily collected with specific machines. We can stimulate the bone marrow in two ways, either using chemotherapy, intermediate dose chemotherapy with the help of G-CSF, or using exclusively G-CSF, which is a stimulating factor of some of the colonies that we have in the bone marrow. But in some situations, there is a small percentage of patients that, because of the age, because of the number of chemotherapy protocols they have received before the mobilization strategy, the pool of stem cells in the bone marrow is not so high, and they need additional drugs to mobilize enough numbers of peripheral blood stem cells. And this new drug, or not so new drug, is plerixafor, that it's usually combined either with G-CSF or with chemotherapy plus G-CSF to increase the mobilization capacity and to increase the number of circulating stem cells into the peripheral blood. In lymphoma patients, and this is kind of a survey between or amongst many European centers, we usually prefer the combination of chemotherapy plus G-CSF plus minus plerixafor if the patient does not mobilize properly to collect these stem cells. These stem cells are being frozen after the collection in specific conditions, and they are kept frozen until the patient receives the conditioning regimen, the high-dose chemotherapy for the autologous stem cell transplant. These stem cells then are thawed, and they are immediately infused through a central venous line into the patient.